How old are you?
24 years old.
The savior thought to himself. When I was a savior in Tashkent, you were about 5 or 6 years old. Life is a shot. Have you been to our yard?
I've been a guest many times, he said. Savior, your grandfather was alive at that time.
Hassan Ali, who was sitting on the sidelines listening to them, said, You were a young boy when your uncle came to our yard, sir. Your uncle would take you to palaces.
Otabek looked at the box with a shy smile.
Unfortunately, I can't remember, he said.
Qutador wanted to say something again, but Akram Haji did not allow him.
What is our brother Haji doing today?
Otabek, Tashkent stand next to the Bigi with the quality of a consultant.
Is Azizbek still the governor of Tashkent?
That's right.
Let the salesman go, Aziz Bachshah Deng, said Homid, and Akram laughed at the pilgrim.
Recently, some of the Muslim cripples were read with this holy kid, he said, looking proudly at the meeting, as if he had discovered something great.
Homid's unnecessary guilt investigation seemed to lie dormant in the meeting, and they looked at each other.
This inappropriate investigation sent the meeting into a bit of silence, and then on the question of Akram Haji he continued, Is it true that your governor is very cruel?
That's right, said the prince. The population is very fed up with Azizbek's oppression.
Not only Akram Haji, but also other members of the assembly were surprised by Otabek's answer.
It was truly surprising to admit the tyranny of a prince who was the velinmat of his father.
Azizbek's atrocities against the people of Tashkent, one of the most tyrannical and tyrannical princes of the Turkestan Khanate, and the people of Tashkent under his control, are epic to Fergana, but Akram Haji's question was to test the son of a man who was closest to Azizbek. The result of this test astonished Haji Akram, and he was curious to know the secret.
Your father is Azizbek's advisor, said Haji Akram.
I'm sorry, uncle, said Otabek with a smile.
My father is Azizbek's advisor and although he is considered a close interlocutor, but this is only a minor matter, let me give you an example. It happened only recently, at one of the Friday speeches in Tashkent, one man praised Azizbek and the other said, Why do you praise him so much?
He says. One of the secret agents, who overhears their conversations from the sidelines, brings the word to Azizbek's ears. The next day, Azizbek brought the two men to him and gave him a great job. When my father, who was present at the trial, asked about the guilt of the convict, Azizbek shouted at the executioner, Take him out as soon as possible. When my father was enslaved again, he ordered the executioner, Loosen your handcuffs and take the pilgrim instead.
You see, my father's dignity.